Pancreatic cancer, early signs of a serious problem. Among all cancers, pancreatic cancer is probably the most feared. With this diagnosis, one has up to 5 years to live. That's why we want to make a concerted effort to prevent this disease, as treatments have not been effective so far. There are early signals, which are the way your body sends you a message to tell you that something is wrong and that you need to consult a doctor immediately. In this video, we'll show you what the first signs of pancreatic cancer are, what causes increase the risk of developing pancreatic cancer, and what lifestyle habits do, and finally, what natural remedies are available in addition to medical treatments if you have already been diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. Yellowish skin, blood sugar spikes, abdominal pain for no particular reason, whitish stools, increasingly dark urine. These are some of the symptoms of advanced pancreatic cancer. Unfortunately, however, these symptoms appear when the problem has already progressed and metastases have occurred. For this reason, pancreatic cancer is unfortunately one of the deadliest cancers, which is only identified when it is fully advanced. The pancreas is a highly specialized organ and performs two main functions. The first is endocrine, which means it releases hormones into the blood that influence the entire body. These two hormones are insulin and glucagon. You're already familiar with the hormone insulin, which I've talked about in other videos, and it's only useful when you follow a carbohydrate-rich diet, as these are accurately assimilated and transported into cells to be burned as energy. The other is glucagon, which works in opposition to insulin and raises blood glucose levels when they drop too low. And the pancreas also plays an important role in the digestive system. Together with the gallbladder and bile, it produces enzymes useful for dissociating and breaking down ingested food. It also produces lipase to digest fats, amylase to digest carbohydrates, and enzymes to break down proteins and amino acids. When a tumor forms in this organ, two functions are altered, the endocrine and the exocrine, and symptoms may appear that require immediate examination. The first and most common is abdominal pain. As the tumor grows and presses on nerves, the pain can be felt even if the cause is unclear. Back pain or muscle inflammation can also cause abdominal pain, but this pain has a mechanical character, increasing with exertion or muscle contraction and decreasing when the patient is at rest. In contrast, the pain characteristic of pancreatic tumors can increase immediately after eating or during the night, when pancreatic enzymes are wasted due to prolonged fasting. This is because the pancreatic enzymes are expelled into the intestine to digest food. However, if a tumor obstructs the ducts that carry the enzymes into the intestine, these same enzymes will go to the pancreas to digest it. This mechanism explains in more detail why people start to feel pain. Not when they exercise or lift weights, but especially right after eating, perhaps when they have consumed too much fat. As soon as the food enters the mouth or stomach, the pancreas is already alerted to produce enzymes. If these are not expelled, the area becomes inflamed and pain begins to be felt. The next thing that is noticed as a consequence of poor digestion of food is unexplained weight loss. You continue to eat the same food, but you start to lose weight. The enzymes that break down food are no longer available and nutrients cannot be absorbed. You don't gain weight when you eat, but you lose weight when you eat. As soon as the ingested fats are no longer broken down by the digestive enzymes, they appear in the stools. White stools are the hallmark of excess fat, confirmed by the fact that they float in water. The pancreas, along with the gallbladder, plays a role in digestion, and these two organs are connected by a common duct that carries enzymes to the intestine. If this duct is compressed by a possible pancreatic tumor, the bile produced in the gallbladder is also less likely to be expelled into the intestine and remains in circulation. The skin, especially the extremities of the limbs, turns yellow, as do the eyes. To counteract this excess substance, the body tries to expel it through the kidneys. When you use the bathroom, you may notice that your urine changes color and turns a dark brown like Coca-Cola. This is a characteristic of excess of this substance in the blood, which indicates that something is wrong in the digestive system and that you may be suffering from pancreatic cancer. Itching, skin rashes, redness of the skin, and changes in the nails are other symptoms that indicate that something is wrong in the body and that there is an excess of toxic substances that are not being expelled. For a more in-depth video on nail disorders, click here. Peripheral disorders such as nails on the hands and feet are common features of a body disorder in which toxic substances accumulate without being expelled. If, on the other hand, the endocrine function of the pancreas is compromised, that is, its ability to produce insulin or glucagon, the most common sign is the level of blood tests. in which blood sugar spikes are observed without any direct link to what you eat or drink, and sometimes of an uncontrolled type 1 or even a sudden drop, with the typical consequences of type 2 diabetes. If blood glucose levels become too high due to a lack of insulin, the person may experience thirst and hunger, and in older people may need to go to the bathroom more often. Watch this video by clicking here above, which explains all the signals of excess blood sugar. These can be the first signs indicating that something is wrong with the pancreas. However, if you have a tumor in this part of the body, on the contrary, you may have an excessive amount of insulin, which can cause blood sugar to drop to extremely low levels, making you tired, faint, sweat excessively, have a rapid heartbeat, and perhaps become confused and lose your sense of orientation and self-awareness more than once. If you suffer from any of these symptoms, it is worth consulting a doctor immediately. Don't worry, sometimes these symptoms are simply related to other causes, but talking to a doctor is a great way to check and monitor the situation. Unfortunately, in reality, as I said at the beginning of the video, for pancreatic cancer it may be too late because it cannot be prevented with screening, and once you realize you have pancreatic cancer, the chances of recovery are really minimal because it is difficult to treat. This is because pancreatic cancer is a systemic problem. In other words, it's not just one part of the body that's not working, but the entire system. The system that works in such a way as to cause inflammation, cause cellular changes, increase angiogenesis in that area, increase resistance to cell death, and suppress the immune system is altered. At the root of the increase in pancreatic cancer are three main factors that we can modify. The first, currently recognized, is exposure to asbestos. Historically, there are three main phases of increased pancreatic cancer due to asbestos exposure. 1. Miners involved in asbestos extraction. There was a clear increase in pancreatic and liver cancer among workers in these mines. 2. Masons who used this material in building construction. 3. Workers exposed to asbestos. There was a clear increase in pancreatic cancer among construction workers. Here too, the increase in pancreatic, liver, and other types of tumors is directly related to the group of workers who worked in construction. And today, a third wave is once again hitting those living in asbestos-based buildings and releasing this material into the environment, which in recent years has deteriorated and is toxic to the human body. These are people who work in food chains related to poultry. It is believed that some of the viruses present in poultry can be transmitted to humans when handling raw meat before cooking. People working in the food companies that produce the chicken we eat on our tables have a 9 times higher risk of pancreatic cancer than those who don't. This incidence is much higher than smoking, the third known cause of developing cancer. Smokers have a 20-30% higher chance of developing this problem than non-smokers. So the risk is doubled, and regardless of XE9, it is 9 times higher in people who work directly with animals, with chickens. These findings highlight that it's not just red meat that increases the direct risk of developing tumors, but that simply handling certain meats can increase the risk of contracting a virus, resulting in DNA alterations that can cause problems. Therefore, it's best to avoid eating chicken from today onwards. Even if it hasn't been established yet, handling raw chicken in the kitchen will undoubtedly lead to an increasing number of viruses in your environment that could attack you. If your immune system is working, this shouldn't be a problem for the rest of your life. However, if your daily diet of chicken increases your daily exposure to these viruses, the risk of developing pancreatic cancer will be higher than it would otherwise be. So what are the alternatives? How can we combat this problem naturally? On the one hand, definitely replace protein derived from meat with that derived from legumes, a staple food for longevity. I've already talked about this in another video, which I recommend you watch by clicking here at the top. From Japan to Sardinia, from Greece to the United States, all people who live beyond 100 years have legumes as a staple food. In the meantime, if you are already sick with cancer, know that there is promising research on turmeric. Turmeric appears to be effective in reducing the progression of cancer, but the studies are very small and the number of cases is small. In this case, which involved 21 patients with confirmed cancer, only 2 recorded a regression after taking daily turmeric supplements. However, it has the advantage of having no side effects. This means there are no side effects. In fact, people were told to eat as much turmeric as they could tolerate. Of these 21 people, one had a temporary remission, another was permanently cured, and the cancer even returned when turmeric supplementation was stopped. This tells us that plants are often one of the biggest and most effective systems for changing our entire body. This is because plants don't just act on one factor, but on the entire body. This is the same advice given to us by the American Institute for Cancer Research. This shows that a plant-based diet is the right choice to best prevent and manage this problem. Adding whole grains, legumes, vegetables, fruits, and spices is a very useful way to act on the entire body, fight inflammation, lower triglycerides, strengthen the immune system, promote apoptosis, kill weakened cells, and improve stem cell production. By changing our diet, we can really change our entire body and turn negative trends in a healthier direction. Turmeric, like ginger, garlic, rosemary, and many other spices from the plant world, has many properties that we don't yet know about, but which can certainly make a difference. If you have been diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, start incorporating as many plant-based foods, legumes, whole grains, and lots of spices as possible as soon as possible. You'll find that they won't hurt you at all, but they may improve and enhance the effectiveness of your medical treatment. Unfortunately, to be honest, even these interventions may not be enough for those who have already received a diagnosis. However, it is even more important that this information be shared. Perhaps you have already been diagnosed with this problem, or you have seen a loved one affected by this tumor and watched them slowly disappear. Even though it's sad, sharing these stories can help some people learn to prevent rather than cure, and start changing their lives right away. See you in the next video.